a very earned night off considering the shots he has faced this season. The puck is dropped and we are underway here in Seattle in what is a big game for the Kraken as they look to continue to add up the points. It does leave the Ducks without, as Linda mentioned, their two top goal scorers, their two top point producers. Ryan Strome puts it towards the net, and Jones will turn it aside. Simon Benoit rattles it out. Rebound in front. Strome with another shot and another save. Jones scrambled with the puck loose in front. So Seattle going on an early power play.
And here's the chances that we were talking about. You can see the rebounds just get away from Jones a little bit. His first shots of the game, but look at James Schwartz. Gets in behind him.
Max Comtois sends it along the boards. Can't get it out. Now we have a loose puck. And on his wheels is Frank Vetrano. He looks to center. Backhand shot. Jones with the save as it comes off the stick of Max Comtois. Fowler has it at the line. Sends it across. Nesterenko back up top. Fowler sends it across for that one-timer. And Jones will hang on as it comes off the stick of Mason McTavish. Schwartz along the boards. He's got Nathan Beaulieu watching him. Comes away with the puck now in the high slot. Takes the shot. Dostal with the save. Now this is Matty Beniers, puts it at the top. Susie with the long drive, and Dostal will elect to hold.
Seattle's expected to win this game based on the lineup that the Ducks have, but you know that every player is going to compete. There's jobs on the line for next year. There's a little bit of pride in the character that this group is still trying to establish despite a tough year.
Here's Schwartz with the blitz. He scores! The Kraken open the offense. It's 1-0.
In the defensive zone for the Seattle Kraken, just a nice little breakout. And you can see the Ducks all move to the left side, which leaves Schwartz in that pass cross ice wide open. He's looking to see who's coming. And he just blasts this by Dolson, who I think should have this. This is a simple shot from outside. This guy shoots so well that if you can get the goaltender to move ever so slightly out of position, just makes your shot even better.
Johnny Gord with a quick turnaround shot. Dostal with the save. Now out in front. Vince Dunn steps into it, but it's just wide of the net. He puts it to the line. Borgen slides it across for Alexiak. He can't quite handle it, but keeps it onside. Battling away there with Jakob Silverberg. There's a quick shot. Dostal pads that one away. Puts it out in front, but Anaheim will finally get the puck out of their own end. Once again, right back in on McCann. He shoots, save Dostal. McCann following up his own rebound, centers it out in front for Beniers. Beniers with the flicker and the magic in the goal.
Well, you're going to get a look at his hockey IQ here. He recognizes the Ducks need a change. They're desperate. They've been out there a long time in their own zone. Instead of going back in the neutral zone, he just banks it up to Jared McCann and then with sweet hands. And the pass is, it's fluttering a little bit. He has to settle it down. He gets Dostal to bite and go down a little bit too early and then the sweet hands to put it far side. But it really starts with Beniers.
Right out the front! That was on the stick of Morgan Geeky and he might have some nightmares about that as he had an open net but couldn't get it to go. Dunn fires it just wide. Everett coming in. He's watched by Comtois. Held up. Puck pops loose. McCann. Cross ice. Here's Dunn. Thinks about it. Sends it over back to McCann. He takes the shot, but it's redirected out. Johnny Gord working low. Puck shovel around. Kept in here by Alexiak at the point. Back down to Tolvanen. Now dish right up the front. Tolvanen with a quick shot in tight. And Lucas Dostal forced to be sharp as he covers.
For sure, as the Seattle Kraken just took over the game.
That he was, as the Kraken outshot the Anaheim Ducks 16-8. 11 different Kraken players had shots on goals. Wennberg on his backhand, wheeling around. He'll drop it back down low. Meeting it up is Borgen once again. Vetrano's on him. Now at the side of the net, Schwartz with the shot as he walks up with it, but it's turned aside by Dostal. 20 seconds left here on the power play. Fowler skates it in. Nesterenko can't quite hold it. Here's a shorthanded break. This is Tanev. Tanev! Oh, and he's turned aside by Dostal as the net comes off.
Brandon Tanev on the ice, in particular on the penalty kill. Look for him to take off. Just speed right through the middle in the defensive zone. Good positioning, and he gets this chance. And the reason why the whistle wasn't blown is because the Ducks didn't knock this net off.
Silverberg will send this one up to the red line. It is collected by McGinn. McGinn moving around behind Vanetta Jones. Grant in there for support. McGinn takes a shot, and he scores! The Anaheim Ducks are on the score sheet with just over a minute to go in the second. It is now 2-1.
Good play by Scott Harrington. Good defensive zone battles, and it leads to this rush here. A nice little hesitation move by McGinn as he comes wide. It gets in behind the net, and then coverage is just lost as McGinn's able to come out. There's no switch there. You can see Jamie Oleksiak thinking to take Grant, and it's McGinn who's wide open. And they've come with a lot of pride, and they did the job there in the second period.
And they are back in this game, just trailing by one as we head into the third period here from Climate Pledge Arena. He'll rattle this one right back to Petrano. Toronto along the wall. He puts it down low. Right in front. Comtois! And what a shot. And Jones makes a strong save.
Second period has given the Anaheim Ducks some life. And, you know, much like you think back to the McGinn goal, they attack from below the goal line. You can see the nice pass from Strom to Comtois. Not once, but twice. And they found a little bit of a weakness.
Up to the line. Elberg will fire it right back low. Deep behind the net. He's got Shattenkirk on him. Tilborg in front. The defenseman tries to put it through the paint, but it looks like Dostal has held on.
Or has he?
So the Seattle Kraken are up 2-1. The question is, could it be 3-1, or did Dostal hang on here?
Boy, this is really going to be hard to tell because he's pretty much got the goal line covered. Nice little hands here by...
And a quick up here to Strome. Drops it back for Comtois. He thinks about it, fires it. Borgen with the block. Comtois knocks it in. Here's Petrano right in front. Jones with a kick save.
Well, so far, there's no question about that. It's a giveaway in the neutral zone and then again in the defensive zone for the Seattle Kraken. A huge bar scene around the stadium and everyone was there.
Bjorkstrand with the shot. Dostal gets a piece of it. Schultz. Down, but here's with the shot just wide of the net. Puck ricochets right back to Daniel Sprong. He has some space. Sprong takes the shot. And the Daniel Sprong with his 20th goal of the season. With that, it's the first time in Sprong's career that he's hit the 20 goal mark.
Well, he just recognizes the time and space given to him. Look at all the time and space, and he just attacks right to the dot, and he just has all the time in the world to put this shot exactly where he wants, far side, as Fowler gets caught a little flat-footed as he's trying to play the two-on-one.
Fowler cross ice, nice look. There's a shot. Jones gets a piece of it. Dostal is to the box for, or to the box, how about to the bench?
The Anaheim players actually realize that the goaltender had been pulled. As you can see, they start to back up.